Stranger Things seemed to come out of nowhere to become one of television's standout new series in 2016. Netflix is sometimes scary, sometimes funny, an always exciting homage to 80s pop culture was a binge-worthy phenomenon when it debuted in July 2016. Of course, the streaming giant wasn't going to wait long to bring more Stranger Things to audiences, and a second season was announced a little over a month after its debut, and Netflix just announced that we'll be getting it a few days earlier than expected. Here are five key things we know about the show's sophomore season, which kicks off on October 27. 1. We'll be getting even more episodes. The first season of Stranger Things consisted of 8-hour-long episodes, which proved to be a solid length for the story Matt and Ross Duffer wanted to tell. While season 2 won't increase in length dramatically, we will be getting at least one extra hour when the show returns in 2017 with 9 episodes. Not much is known about any of these episodes, but we do know the titles Mad Max, The Boy Who Came Back to Life, The Pumpkin Patch, The Palace, The Storm, The Pollywog, The Secret Cabin, The Brain, The Lost Brother. There's a lot of speculation about what each title means, and, as usual with Stranger Things, there's probably a reason for each one. Some doors can't be closed. STRANGERTHINGS2 arrives on October 27th. pic.twitter.com/5calc, Stranger Things at Stranger Things July 11, 2017 2. The kids are returning including 11. Stranger Things fans should gear up for plenty of new developments in Season 2, but that doesn't mean your favorite characters aren't returning. A November 4 photo sent out by the show's Twitter account revealed most of the kids from the first season will be back in 2017, including the enigmatic 11, played by Millie Bobby Brown. The 11 is back hashtag used by series regular Finn Wolfhard should really drive the point home. Suyuniyipsy who know why acute why acutes you o want and point you want tpq pic.twitter.com/jyd1spry, Stranger Things at Stranger Things November 4, 2016 3. The show's 1984 setting will lead to a darker tone. A year will have passed between the first and second seasons of the show, allowing the Duffer brothers to catch up with a familiar cast of characters that has matured since we last saw them. With the story taking place in 1984, the brothers are looking at the pop culture zeitgeist at the time for inspiration, most notably the darker tone of blockbusters like Gremlins and Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom. I actually really love Temple of Doom. I love that it gets a little darker and weirder from Raiders. I like that it feels very different than Raiders did, Matt Duffer told Ine. Even though it was probably slammed at the time, obviously now people look back on it fondly, but it messed up a lot of kids, and I love that about that film, that it really traumatized some children. Not saying that we want to traumatize children, just that we want to get a little darker and weirder. 4. It's not so much a continuation as it is a sequel. When you watch something like The American Season 2, it's almost impossible to catch on, unless you have seen the previous episodes. Stranger Things Season 2 will differ from the modern TV approach by being more of a sequel than a continuation of the first year. That means a more self-contained plot that doesn't leave viewers hanging at the end of 9 episodes. There are lingering questions, but the idea with Season 2 is there's a new tension, and the goal is can the characters resolve that tension by the end, Ross Duffer told Ine. So it's going to be its own sort of complete little movie, very much in the way that Season 1 is. Don't worry about the two seasons of Stranger Things being too similar or too different from the original, though, because when speaking with Entertainment Weekly about the influences on the show, Matt Duffer said, "I guess a lot of this is James Cameron. But he's brilliant. And I think one of the reasons his sequels are as successful as they are is he makes them feel very different without losing what we loved about the original. So I think we kinda look to him and what he does and try to capture a little bit of the magic of his work." 5. The premiere will travel outside of Hawkins. Everything about the new Stranger Things episodes will be kept secret until they finally debut later this year, but we do know one thing about the premiere: it won't take place entirely in the familiar town of Hawkins, Indiana. "We will venture a little bit outside of Hawkins," Matt Duffer told Entertainment Weekly. "I will say the opening scene of the premiere does not take place in Hawkins. So, should we take a little bit outside as literally as it sounds? You certainly can. But in that same interview, the brothers also said they're both eager to explore the Upside Down, the alternate dimension from the first season. Whether the season kicks off just a few miles away, or a few worlds away, y'all get your answer when Stranger Things' second season debuts next month.